We're back and you're watching Live at 9, world-renowned oncologist Dr. Bill West, also founded the West Cancer Center right here in Memphis, and now he's taking on a different role of sorts.
That's right. The scientist decided to investigate some of the deepest mysteries of life and life after death. And for the next several weeks, Dr. West will challenge audiences to explore faith and science at One Mid-South Church. This morning, we're joined by Dr. West and Reverend Shane Stanford.
Nice to meet you.
Who is the chief pastor at Christ Church Memphis, beginning Wednesday, 4 weeks.
That's right.
So, as a scientist, sometimes we think science and faith are like polar opposites. What brought you to what many would consider a different place?
Well, you know, as an oncologist, I've had an opportunity to be involved in science since I was a very young person.
Mm-hmm.
And ironically, it's through my church and a small group there that I continued to study the broader issues of science. The founder of our small group, Dick Ross, was the president of Buckman Labs.
Okay.
He had a PhD in microbiology.
Okay.
And he said, look, you've got this fancy scientific education. Help me. You'd be a backup teacher. And give us an update every once or twice a year on science and faith. So it's really been a lifelong journey. I was driven to this series by the observation that 40% of 18 to 30-year-olds say they have no religious affiliation.
40%.
40%, and the reason they give is science conflicts with faith.
Which you disagree with, obviously.
100%.
Wow. So, Reverend, when you heard Dr. West was working on this, what thoughts initially, you know, came to mind for you?
Well, we started Christ Academy. Another doctor in the church actually gave a gift to help do more lay education in a deeper way. And so this is a four-week Christ Academy class. And to have someone of Dr. West's renowned, I mean, this is a guy that finished at Johns Hopkins, the National Institutes of Health. I mean, he knows his work.
Right.
But he's also a person who has been so faithful to look at the broader picture. I just knew this was, and I agree with him on the statistics, so many people feel that faith and science conflict, but what we're finding actually is that classical Darwinism is breaking down. The more they talk about the genetic discoveries, they see things that are so organized that you begin to think this could not just simply be some accident.
Things right. such as what, for example?
Yeah, give us an example.
Talk about DNA, for example.
Well, you know, the whole thesis of Darwinism is chance, randomness.
Okay. Right.
Therefore, no need for God. What's happened in science is we now actually look at the genome, the DNA, look at the mutations, and they're not accidental. Unrelated life forms or distantly related life forms are using the same exact mutations to adapt. 200 species of animals that use echolocation use the exact same repertoire of genes to do that. The red panda and the black and white panda live on bamboo in China. They're unrelated. They've never had a common ancestor. They have the same 70 identical genes to be able to live on bamboo.
Huh.
So that's simply a refutation of the accidental. It's looking very much like mutations are mathematically organized.
Interesting.
And math is actually probably the one discipline that is moving so fast to help faith find its way, because the organizational nature of math, there are certain constants, and you find these continuously now that this genetic discussion has happened.
Mm.
You also will talk about life after death, which is certainly, as an oncologist, something that you have had to help patients
with your entire career. It's actually a broader topic. How can we have this conversation? How did we get this higher consciousness? The universe unrolls in this beautiful blueprint of math. How can we read the math? And then just, what is a near-death experience? What is an out-of-body experience?
Has it helped you help your patients or the patient's families with a belief that this isn't it?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Now, I would say, and I don't want to speak for every provider at the West Cancer Center, but almost all bring faith. It's hard not to when you're practicing cancer medicine.
Mm-hmm.
And most patients respond to that and appreciate that.
I bet.
And very quickly here, Doctor, are we trying to change views here or just have a discussion?
I'm trying to change a lot of views. Interestingly, I'm trying to change the views of people of faith. They're so scared of science, Yes. They escape it.
Wow.
That makes sense.
Fascinating
makes
for sure.
Every
gentlemen, thank you so much.
Wednesday.
So it starts Wednesday. You don't have to be a member of Christ Church
to come.
No
fee. Just show up.